The Green Party co-leader James Shaw is nursing a black eye and lacerations to his face after an attack in Wellington today that's prompted fears over the security of our MPs. RNZ understands a man jumped out of a van near the Botanical Garden shortly after 7:30 this morning, shouting political comments aimed at the climate change minister personally. Questions are now being raised as to whether politicians are too accessible in this country and whether the political landscape in New Zealand is changing for the worse. Here's political reporter Gia Garrick.
Even an assault didn't deter James Shaw from getting to Parliament this morning. He talked to paramedics and the police at the scene outside the entrance to the Botanical Gardens on Glenmore Street before heading on to work to attend his usual Environment Cabinet Committee meeting. The Agriculture Minister, Damien O'Connor, commended him for the bravado.
I have to give full marks to James. He turned up at CAB Committee with a black eye and bleeding nose, so it's a true commitment to the job, and I hope it comes right quick.
It wasn't until later he checked himself into hospital for a proper checkup. He responded to texts asking if he was okay, saying it looked worse than it was. And Mr Shaw clearly told the Prime Minister, Jacinda Ardern, the same thing.
While he, of course, is, you know, pretty stoic, it is a pretty shocking thing to happen. I think that, you know, we all appreciate and I think probably celebrate the accessibility of our politicians in New Zealand. I think that's obviously something that we want to be able to maintain, but I don't think we can take it for granted either.
There's hope from many, including the Finance Minister Grant Robertson, that politics isn't taking an ugly turn.
One of the things that is really great about New Zealand is the access that people have to politicians and the fact that this is, you know, a country where we don't have the big distance between politicians and people and so on. You know, I certainly hope we can continue that.
Up until now, most politicians in New Zealand have felt relatively free and safe to go about their daily lives in public without security or taking extra safety precautions. The Police Minister, Stuart Nash, says it would be a sad day if every Cabinet Minister had to be accompanied by a security detail.
I would hate to think that we have entered an era where politicians need to be protected like that.
Politicians across the political spectrum united in condemning the attack, calling it horrific and unwarranted. Mr Shaw's climate change counterpart, the National MP Todd Muller, says it's not reflective of the New Zealand he knows.
I don't think one man's punch defines a nation's political discourse. It's far from that in this country and in this Parliament. Indeed, in climate change, we're working hard to develop a bipartisan outcome.
And other MPs have shared stories of times they've felt threatened in public, like the former minister, Paula Bennett.
Yeah, I have in the past. Probably about three occasions come to mind where I felt that I could be physically hurt and have had to have call the police and have assistance for
it. When you were minister?
Yes, it was.
The Green Party co-leader Marama Davidson says she's just grateful for the two members of the public who jumped in to help James Shaw after he'd been hit. They called an ambulance and got in touch with the police.
This is also what I love about New Zealand, is that people will jump in and help, and that's what New Zealand has always been about.
Ms Davidson was keeping to the positives and says she hopes this was just a one-off random attack. The police have arrested and charged a 47-year-old man with injuring with intent to injure. He'll appear in the Wellington District Court tomorrow. From Parliament for Checkpoint, Gia Garrick.